All right, so we're going to work on another very popular strategy for trading investment instruments, and that's going to be the momentum strategy. It's going to be very basic, and it's going to, I think, offer you guys a good outline on setting up your own momentum strategy. So, of course, we're going to use Y Finance. I think Y Finance is a great package to practice these packages on. If you need more granular detail, there's other videos I've made on Alpha Vantage and whatnot. But Y Finance is easy to work with, and it doesn't require much computing power. So we're also going to need to get our usual suspects to plot and manipulate the data frames. We're going to work with gold here. We're going to do 2013 to 2023. That's a good 10 years of data that we're going to pull. And just to take a look at it, that's what it is. It's by day. And you can see the kind of data it gives us. So we're just going to take the returns of our adjusted close over each day. And the basic idea of a momentum strategy is if the last return was positive, we're going to buy. And if the last return was negative, we're going to sell. The idea is assuming if the returns or the movement of the finance instrument is going in one direction, it's going to keep going into that direction. And once it changes, we're going to switch it up. And you can see here, we have our returns. And this is the orange line is the strategy. So in this instance, the strategy is not working very well. The returns, for some reason, it doesn't capture this movement here. And it doesn't really capture this movement here. Even if it does, the returns on our strategy just doesn't outpace the actual returns of just the actual instrument itself. So let's try it a little differently. Let's say if the returns are on a, let's say if the last three returns is positive, then we'll buy. And if the last three returns were negative, then we'll sell. So essentially setting up the same thing, only we're doing the last three instead of each and every one. You can see here our strategy does significantly better because it's saying that there's an actual movement in the price. There's an actual momentum in the price. Since the last 3 days we're going up, we're assuming that the fourth day will also go up. So yeah, pretty simple. We can also do that intraday, as you might suspect. Intraday is probably a lot better suited for this kind of strategy. Instead of going day by day, we can set like a certain hour by hour or minute by minute. In our case, we're going to do every 1 minute, and we're going to be using Tesla. In this instance, I wanted to pick something sort of volatile to see what it'd be like. Here you can see I'm using the Alpha Vantage now. So you can see this is what the Alpha Vantage data frame returns to us, and we've got it by the minute. Each minute here. I've just set the timestamp as the index. We're going to take the close. We're going to get the returns on that. And we're going to try several different strategies for this. So we're going to set it as each one return, every three returns, every five returns, every seven, and every nine. And we're going to see which ones do the best. And we're going to plot it. And you can see that none of our strategies really work that well with Tesla in this instance. It looks like the purple line came the closest. What's purple? Every seven. So even with intraday, I think you'd need to play around with it, as well as maybe a different stock type. I haven't done this before, just setting this up. But let's change Tesla to maybe something like, I don't know, Apple. And we'll go through the same process here, see what we get. And not much of a difference. Seems like all of our strategies aren't doing as well. So by each minute in the day, if we're calculating a momentum by the minute, maybe not as effective. Interesting. So you can see, though, that with the gold, it seemed to work very well daily, with Tesla and Apple on every minute. Doesn't seem to work as well. One last thing we can try, instead of every 1 minute, we could try every 5 minutes. Let's just go through it again. And you can see in the beginning that, you know, we're outpacing the Tesla stock at every 5 minutes, but then as time continues to go on, we just keep falling out and the momentum drops. It doesn't follow the momentum as time goes on. So this is a fairly basic momentum strategy that you can outline and implement and play around with. There's certainly more that you can do with momentum strategies, but I thought I'd just stick with the fundamentals for the beginners out there, and partly because also the more advanced topics are difficult for me to really describe in competent detail. So figured I'd stick with the basics for now, just so I know that I'm providing you guys good content. Anyway, I'll keep making videos like this. If you guys like them, let me know in the comments or just by liking the video. It really helps me get an idea of what I should make next and whatnot. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.